again so much for joining me today. And I've been watching this current season of Junior MasterChef, and I'm blown away by the talent of these kids. You know, they're making dishes that I've never heard of, couldn't pronounce, and could only dream of eating. How shocked were you when you saw the level of cooking?
We were over the moon. I mean, of course, we knew that the caliber of contestants applying would be great, because why else would you apply to be on a cooking show? But to see them cook and to really be so self-possessed and to be able to show their character, their personality, their love for their families through their food, I mean, that is, these are skills that take years to develop, and to see it in kids so young and with such good nature and such heart, that just, it was just overwhelmingly wonderful. And I had the most joyous time spending time with these juniors. They're just brilliant.
Well, we have seen a few Indian dishes. We've seen a chai tea deconstruction of a tart. We've seen Mughlai chicken being made in the kitchen. What do you feel about Indian flavors? And do you think it is something that's going to be major in the food trends in the coming few years?
I think it's absolutely extraordinary to see young people tackle such complex and diverse flavors, because of course, India is one of the great ancient cuisines of the world. It is incredibly diverse across all of the states. There are such nuances, and it takes, you know, generations to perfect these really small details. And so to have, you know, 10, 13 year old kids just absolutely, you know, show their family and show their true understanding of their roots through food, I mean, to me, that's so inspiring to watch. And it's almost unbelievable. If I wasn't there, you know, tasting it for myself, you could almost not believe it. So I think that Indian cuisine is, you know, it's one of the great cuisines of the world, and to see it treated with such care by such young contestants is incredible. I think that in Australia especially, we have a long way to go in terms of really grasping how special Indian cuisine is in all of its fine nuance. But that's the exciting part of it, is it's a journey forward. It's a journey of discovery for many. And it's more than just a few simple dishes. It's a lifetime of experience, isn't it?
Always good to hear nice things about our cuisine, for sure. And thank you for that. And
I love Indian cuisine. I could talk about it all day, so don't worry about that.
That's the answer that we want. Yeah, that is the answer that we want. So I love Indian cuisine.
Yeah.
So, shooting in COVID times, I see these socially distanced fist bumps that happen. It must be so tempting to give these kids a hug, you know, for all the amazing food that they cook, but everything has to be from a distance and all the safety precautions have to be in place.
That's it. It would be lovely to at least be able to high five, you know, in a traditional sense, but we can't do that in these current circumstances. But the wonderful thing about working with kids in that regard is that you don't ever need to tell them twice. They understand what's going on in the world. They listen and they take everything on. And as much as they would love to hug each other and to high five us and you know, to be a bit more tactile with it, you know, we understand that it is a great privilege to continue to make television in these times. And being on a food show, we are already at the height of hygiene. You know, when it comes to hospitality, restaurants and you know, TV food shows are all about, you know, making sure that everything is safe in terms of our workplace. But beyond that, you know, the closeness that we feel, we still feel it in our hearts. And I think that it's just extra encouragement for us to continue to use our words to express how we feel and to convey that respect to our, you know, to our contestants and to each other. So yeah, it's tough, but we feel very lucky as well to be able to continue to make a show that is just gives us all a little bit of a break from the worries and the stresses of what's going on.
Well, absolutely. And we love watching it too. And the class of 2020 seems to be incredibly smart. Do you think technology has a lot to do with this? Because they've been watching YouTube videos from home. They've been learning cooking from there.
Absolutely. I think technology has a lot to say in terms of how our younger generations and how we all learn these days. We are all connected through technology in that regard. You know, without technology, I wouldn't be able to be, doing this interview with you right now, you know, in our homes. It really gives me extra gratitude to know that we can still remain connected throughout, you know, whatever's going on. But yeah, these kids grew up with MasterChef. You know, MasterChef's been on for over a decade in Australia, and some of these kids are 10, so it's been on longer than they've been alive. So they've grown up watching amazing food TV shows, they've grown up with the internet where they can research things, they can go, oh, what's that dish, and go and research it, learn how to make it. And that's how you have an 11 or a 12 year old make choux pastry. It's crazy.
Absolutely. And the dishes that you get to taste look so exemplary. How do you manage to pack in so much in one episode? Because there's quite an array and you all take some generous bites of all that food.
Well, Jock can eat the most. I think that is clear. Jock can eat all the food and do all of the tastings and the judgings and still eat, a full
six
lunch.
Donuts.
And breakfast. I think that day he ate 18 donuts in total. And that's not including lunch. I think he ate a whole fried chicken and chips and a whole lot of other things, salad and things like that, as well as 18 donuts. That's insane. Andy and I are a little bit more balanced about the way that we approach food. We both, of course, love food just as much as Jock, but we also really love to exercise and we take a little bit more moderation when it comes to maybe I'll take a bite, not eat the whole donuts. Fortunately, we have a closed loop compost system, so no food is ever wasted. It all goes back into recycling and then nourishes the garden that grows the vegetables for our wonderful challenges as well. So it's everything has a place. Not all of it needs to be in my stomach though.
Do people tell you that when they watch MasterChef they get all these cravings, especially when you watch it at night before going to sleep? You can't resist a midnight snack. It's so tough.
You can have a midnight snack if you want to. I'm not stopping you. But no, look, it's wonderful. I think it's the best it's the best review we could possibly receive, is to have people say, I watched the show and now I really want to eat whatever it is that we saw. That's great.
Yeah, that's exactly what happens to me. And this interview has also made me so hungry, hearing about the 18 donuts that Jock has. Thank you so much for joining me, Melissa.
My absolute pleasure.